We'll begin the program with our top story, starting from the southeastern part of Nigeria, where the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, on Friday released the list of cleared candidates for the November 6th governorship elections in Anambra State. Now missing on the list is the name of governorship candidate of the All Progressive Grand Alliance, APGA, in the person of Charles Soludo and his running mate, Onyekachi Ibezim.
Now, both Soludo and Ibezim were replaced with Chukwuma Umeoji and Obiageli Orogbu as the candidates and deputy governorship candidates of the APGA, that's the APGA party. Now, also removed from the list of candidates of the People's Democratic Party, that's the PDP, Valentine Uzigbo, and deputy governorship candidates due to the submitting court order on the primary that produced them. Now, INEC, however, cleared the candidates of All Progressive Congress as the APC, Andrew Uba, and the deputy governorship candidate, John Bosco Anedobi, as well as the candidates of the YPP, that's Ifeanyi Uba. Now, to bring clarity to some of the questions being asked by many Nigerians on the list, is INEC National Commissioner and Chairman, Information and Education Committee, Barrister Festus Okoye, who joins us this morning on Breakfast. Barrister Festus, good morning. Welcome to Breakfast Central.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning, Barrister Festus. Now, we'd like to start by getting your view on the present situation of things in Anambra State ahead of the polls in November.
Well, the present situation is that we are clearly and irrevocably committed to the timetable and schedule of activities we released in relation to the Anambra governorship election. As you know, because it is a standalone election, it's an off-season election, the commission decided to release the timetable and schedule of activities in January this year. So to enable and give all the political parties sufficient time, one, to put their house in order, and two, to conduct what we call valid party primaries. So since January, the political parties were given a copy of our timetable and schedule of activities. So what we have done is that we have followed methodically the timetable and schedule of activities, and we just released the list and personal particulars of the candidates that have emerged from their party primaries. And this is consistent with our timetable. In fact, we are on the number six, item six on our timetable and schedule of activities as we released out of 14 items. We are now on number six. So that is where we are.
All right, Barrister Festus. Now, your commission released the list of cleared candidates on Friday. And there were, you know, some concerns that, you know, really raise a bit of eyebrows and a bit of it. Why is the PDP not on that list? Now, because according to the Electoral Act, INEC relates with the National Working Committee of Parties to get their candidates' name. Now, which candidate's name did your commission receive?
Let me put it this way. By our own rules and by our own procedures, the commission relates with the National Executive Committee of the different political parties as you asserted. And this is consistent with the provisions of Section 87 of the Electoral Act, which mandates the National Executive Committee of the various political parties to organize party primaries. Secondly, we not only relate with the National Executive Committee of the political parties, we also give access code to our candidates nomination portal to the national chairman of the political party, as recognized by the Independent National Electoral Commission. And as you are aware, 18 of the registered political parties gave the commission notice of their intention to conduct party primaries. Now, the national leadership of the party, of the PDP, for instance, submitted the list, the name of their gubernatorial candidate, and they submitted the name of one Valentine Uzigbo as their gubernatorial candidate for the November 6th governorship election. But before the publication of the list, the commission got two court orders. One, there was a court order from a suit filed by one Genevieve today, which states that the commission should not take any further steps in relation to the publication of the list and personal particulars of the candidates.
Okay.
Then we also got a court order in a suit filed by Valentine Ozibo relating to the same party primaries, wherein he went to court and oiled the court to compel the Independent National Electoral Commission to publish his name as the duly and validly elected nominated candidate of the party. And the court refused to grant him that particular request. So based on the court orders we had, we felt that we need to obey the court order. And obedience to the court order presupposes that we should not publish the name of any of the of any candidate relating to the PDP in Anambra. So it was in compliance with the court order.
But we know, Vice Professor, we know that you know there are two about factional primaries in PDP in Anambra State. Which one of them did INEC monitor out of these two, you know, factions in the PDP in Anambra?
Well, in relation to our processes and in relation to our procedures, we are not aware that there's any faction of the PDP in Anambra State. This is because in accordance with constitutional provisions, every political party that has done Congress or convention and elected any party executives ought to domicile that particular their names with the Independent National Electoral Commission, and they must give the commission 21 days notice of their intention to conduct either a convention, a congress, or a meeting for the purposes of either electing the executives or conducting primaries. So, based on that, when they finish and when we monitor, they submit the list of their elected party executives with the commission. So as far as the commission is concerned, the name of the party executives of the national officers of the PDP that we have are as we have them in our commission, and there has not been any change whatsoever. So we are not aware that there's a faction of the PDP in Anambra State.
Right. Barrister Festus, now we know there is a deadline for the submission of names to INEC. So what happens if these cases get resolved, even though we understand that you're working with just one particular party in terms of looking at the fractions or non-fractions? What happens if the cases within the party get resolved and they want to bring give you a new name? Will INEC still entertain any names at that time?
Well, let me put it this way. The conduct of party primaries and the determination on who is the candidate of a political party is strictly within the domestic realm of the various political parties. Now, the various political parties, the 18 political parties that conducted party primaries and gave the Independent National Electoral Commission the requisite 21 days notice in accordance with Section 85 of the Electoral Act to monitor their party primaries, have submitted the list and personal particulars of the candidates they intend to make their candidates for the election. Now, some of the political parties are in court. If at the end of the day, any of the courts makes a determination that the candidate whose name has been submitted was not the candidate that emerged from the party primary elections of the party, and gives us an order that we should replace that particular candidate with another candidate, we will definitely comply with the said court order. Okay. But in terms of a party organizing fresh party primaries and nominating fresh candidates, that particular period has completely elapsed, and we cannot go back to it.
All right, quite an interesting stance by INEC. Now, Bryce, before we let you go, let's talk about ABGA itself and the exclusion of Charles Soludo, who's quite a known name, from the list of cleared candidates. Now, the Victor Oye faction is denying that Jude Okeke is not a member of the ABGA party. Tell us quickly, what played out here?
Well, as far as this particular commission is concerned, the national chairman of ABGA, recognized by the Independent National Electoral Commission, is Victor Oye. The commission is not aware that any new convention or any new leadership has been elected for ABGA. So based on our own processes and based on our procedures and based on what we have in the commission, Victor Oye is the national chairman of ABGA. Now, they conducted their party primaries. The Independent National Electoral Commission was given the requisites 21 days notice. And we did monitor the party primaries by the party primaries of the primaries conducted by the Victor Oye-led National Executive Committee of the party. But, and then they submitted the list, the name of a candidate and his personal particulars. But we got a court order, a final judgment from a Jigawa High Court that sat in Benin, Kudu, saying that Wanjudo Keke is the acting national chairman of ABGA, and that we must accept the name and the list of candidates submitted by the Victor, by the Judo Keke led National Executive Committee, so to say, of ABGA. And then we also got a second court order saying that it is the list of that particular, the list and personal particulars submitted by the Judo Keke faction, so to say, of the party that we should publish. And that's exactly what we have done. And all of them are aware that they have multiple court cases in court. And I want to say that it is important before we get to the 20 November 6th governorship election for the political parties to put their houses in order. In some of the political parties, we have court orders and court judgments from relating to an election that will take place in Anambra. We have court orders from almost all the six geopolitical zones. And maybe what we are waiting for now will be when we are going to get a court order from the from ECOWAS court, and one maybe from the African court. So I think that the political parties should put their house in order and not use the judiciary to create confusion in relation to the conduct of the elections in Anambra State.
Right. Thank you. Thank you for coming on the show today, Barrister Festus Okoye, INEC National Commissioner and Chairman, Information and Education Committee.
Thank you very much, Barrister Okoye.
I really appreciate it.
Thank you.